why would you want to update a 10-year-old laptop? There are many reasons, not just to do with saving money. It's about saving a load of money, right? Plus the fact you can't get laptops with this functionality these days. They just don't make them. And I was astonished by how fast this thing is. It's really snappy now that I've done the upgrades on it. And I'll also show you how to optimize Windows so that it stays fast over a long period of time.
We've got separate headphone and microphone jacks, USB 3, USB 2, HDMI, Ethernet connection, and a VGA graphics adapter. On the other side, we've got DC power in, USB 2, and an optical drive so you can burn CDs and DVDs and that kind of thing. We've got a full-size keyboard, stereo speakers, SD card reader, and a 1-megapixel webcam. Go to the Microsoft website, sign in with your Microsoft account, and you're going to download the media creation tool to your desktop, and then you're going to run that and you're going to create a boot disk with your USB drive. That's what we're going to use to boot this thing up. Now, anything that's on that drive is going to be obliterated, so make sure you clear it before you start. You're going to need a Phillips head screwdriver, an SSD, I've got one here from Kingston. Be careful what you do when you're buying these. Don't buy the ultra cheap ones. You need a SATA cable as well, and that will be coming in useful afterwards, but also for now we're going to just test to see if it's recognized by the system. So you plug that in, plug the USB side into the laptop, and you'll see it's, the lights are flashing but it's not showing up. So you need to create a partition on that disk. In the search bar, type create, and this disk partition creation tool will pop up. Just click on the first thing that you see. It's already selected, and you'll see here the disk is actually being recognized, but it hasn't been initialized or formatted. So we follow these steps and it will start to format the disk. And because it's not been formatted before, it will come up with an error. But all you do is just right mouse click on the disk icon at the bottom and format that area into a single volume. This takes literally a couple of seconds. Just say yes, yes, yes to all of this because it'll all be configured correctly. You can check the disk partition size if you want, but it's going to know what it is. And eventually you'll see after a couple of seconds that it will say it's one formatted drive. And that's it, it's done. As you can see, the lights are flashing and the formatting is finished. It's one single volume. Unplug the SSD from the laptop, turn the laptop off, and remove the battery, take your Phillips head screwdriver and undo the back panel. And while you're here,
double the RAM. This is a Toshiba Satellite and it will take up to 16 gig of RAM. Then clip it down. That's it.
Here you can see the old hard drive. It's in a silver caddy and it just slides out. It's a SATA drive, so it doesn't have a separate power. It takes its power from the laptop. Take the silver caddy off with four screws and keep it because we're going to use that, because it's also a heat sink. So put your new SSD into the caddy and slide it into the hard disk spot. You'll notice these SSDs are very flimsy and plasticky, but the actual components inside there are tiny, but they have to be mounted into this plastic casing in order to fit. So that's why they're so big, but they're tiny actually. Replace the back cover, turn it over, boot up the laptop while holding down F2 or F12. And that will get you into the BIOS. So plug in your boot disk. This one was very loose fitting and it caused a few problems, but I've left it in the video so you can see what happens. Yeah, this was a bit of a nightmare. I didn't realize what was going on. I didn't realize that the USB was so loose. So I kept on messing around with it. So this kept happening quite a few times and I just kept going back into the BIOS settings and making sure that the USB was seen. It was showing up as the first boot device, but it wasn't being recognized because that should have had some details on it. So anyway, I just jiggled about a bit and kept messing around and kept failing. And many boot attempts later, I just propped up the USB and it booted up. So now all you've got to do is sit back and let Windows do its thing and pick your keyboard, whatever country you're in. That's it, just sit back. Your internet will be detected and you put in your network password. And that's it, just sit back and relax while they work their magic. The Windows installation took about 20 minutes in total. And now you'll realize why I said sign in with your Microsoft account, because at this stage, as it's booting up, it will ask for an activation key. So you just type in your email address and off it goes. After the Windows installation finishes, just go to the update site and update all your drivers. So now we've got a clean installation of Windows, we want to optimize it so that it runs fast all the time. So create a restore point, clean up your startup menu and get rid of things that you don't use. I don't like all those tiles, so I'll get rid of all those tiles on the start menu and get rid of other optional things that are running in the background. They all take up resources and you know you don't use them, so get rid of them. One of the easiest ways to optimize Windows is to not fill your machine up with stuff. So your old hard drive, you can connect to your laptop with the SATA cable. This is an optional step, but it's one that I do. And then copy all your files, photographs and videos onto an external hard drive and leave the Windows machine only for working on. So you take files into the machine, you work on them, you take them back off again. That way, your Windows machine will be optimized long term and it won't slow down.
You may notice a difference in the lighting of this scene. It's a different day and I'm using natural light because it saves on electricity, which makes sense. Now, let's talk about the specs and the cost of doing this upgrade. The specs on this Toshiba Satellite C850, it's an Intel i3 processor and it had 8 gigs of RAM, 2 sticks of 4. I took those out and I took them to a place called CEX. I traded them in and got 16 gig of RAM, 2 sticks of 8, for £7. So that was cheap. The solid state drive, or SSD, was £24.50 from Kingston. And the SATA cable was about £7.20 or something like that. There'll be links in the description. Be careful when you're buying one of these SSDs. Don't go for the dirt cheap ones, because I've seen some YouTubers who have reviewed them, those cheap ones. And they open them up. They've got an SD card in them with 32 gig of memory. So they're useless. It's just basically fraud. So really be careful when you're doing that. And also be careful, when you're buying stuff on the internet, it's a bit of a crapshoot, but at least with Amazon you've got a 30-day money-back guarantee, I think. I bought a new battery, but that was the third battery I'd tried. I tried two other batteries and they just didn't work. They were dead on arrival, but the third one I got was okay, worked fine. The specs of the Toshiba is interesting because that Intel i3 processor has got onboard graphics, and that means it can access 4 gigabytes of system memory and call it VRAM. So I was really surprised when I ran this thing, when it was all up and running, it runs so fast. I was like, what the hell, has never been this fast. And so I thought, let me give it a test. So I downloaded DaVinci Resolve and it worked. It passed all the, DaVinci Resolve tests to say that it was compatible to work, and it actually worked. I was like very, very surprised. Anyway, that's another video. If you want me to do a video on DaVinci Resolve used on this laptop, make a comment and I'll think about it. The thing is, the functionality of that laptop is so superior to anything that's out there today, except for there's one competitor. Linus Tech Tips is an investor in it. I can't think what it's called now. But anyway, B But you can't get laptops that you can upgrade these days. They're just like all soldered on and it's just a mess. It's not the thinnest laptop in the world and it's not the most elegant looking laptop in the world. But also, if you're in a coffee shop using this, no one's going to steal it, right? Because it's an ugly looking beast, but it works brilliantly. It's like one of those things that the American guys used to do years ago. They'd have an old jalopy and they'd put a V8 engine in it, you know, and like surprise everyone, stealth, like a stealth car. This is like a stealth laptop. It functions very, very well. It's not difficult to do this upgrade and you don't need any other software. You don't need to do any cloning. You just use the software that comes with Microsoft Windows and it's quite straightforward. And it is really, really fast, this laptop. It's never been this fast in the entire 10 years I've had it. It's never been this quick. And you can render 4K videos on this thing. All you do is you create a proxy, you edit it with the proxy. When you come to export it, you just change the values to 4K or 2.7K or 1080p or whatever you want, and then you export it. Now, this video that you're watching right now was edited on this laptop, on this old 10-year-old laptop, right? And it worked perfectly fine. It took about 30 minutes to export the video, which is fine. I'm in no rush. Yeah, thanks for watching. I'll see you next time. Bye now.